NBC Sports presents the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. The Big Red of Nebraska against the Longhorns of Texas. 64,000 expected under the roof in St. Louis for the first ever Big 12 Championship game. Nebraska dreams of a third title in a row. They want to earn a right to play Florida State in the Sugar, and they hope that Ohio State can handle Arizona State.
Nebraska has done a good job all year covering kickoff.
Beautiful kick. Coming out the 20-yard line. Without an interception, and a little early, Ricky Williams will be lining up behind him. Mike Adams, number 83. If they're going to make the big play with a wide receiver, Adams stretched out a week ago against A&M. The offensive line, Dan Neal, outstanding. But let's see how those tackles, Bishop and Jay Humphrey, hold up here today against Wistrom, who's the right rush in for Nebraska, down in the 3-point. The tackles will have to handle him. The running back helps pick him up, and they snap off a completed pass to Davis. Jason Peter, number 55, had an outstanding sequence against the Buffaloes last Friday in Lincoln. There's Mike Minter. Yes, he'll play Rover, and he will too move up to that rush defensive end spot. So number 10 will again be all over the field as he was last week. And you can see him move up hard on that right side now. Minter getting ready to come, it looks like, on ground on first down. He does, running play, and they will run it right straight ahead. That makes it second and 9. Ricky with a yard. Minter now has moved between tackle and end. Bluff's coming. Brown back. Nails protection goes, and that's, he's 2 for 2, and that is his tight end. Ball's out of bounds. Texas ball. That's a first in. Nakovic is a very creative play caller. Here comes the blitz, and it's the toss package. It's Mitchell trying to get the corner, and he's run out on that far side.
Second and 8. Ball on the Longhorn 44-yard line. And Brown, one to set the screen, now fires deeper, and it is complete. He hit number 8, Wayne McGarrity. And on first down in Nebraska territory, here's Mitchell back in, looking for the corner, turned it upfield, and he powered his way to the 41.
It is second and 6, and the Horns are not backing away from this defense. Horns with another first down. One running back. McAvick changes formations on every play. Brown back, gets time, fires complete. Adams, 25, out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Now Williams comes over to a right wing, sort of offset in the eye, and they're going to run. This is Mitchell, left, and a penalty flag comes down.
Tell us what the situation. Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
I think he's really good inside the red zone area, but he's against the great defense down there as well.
Now Williams in motion, and Brown, a good run, steps to the 5, down at the 4-yard line. A very big move.
They split the backs,
and they counter back with Priest Holmes. Touchdown Texas, like that on the opening drive. Full of fire now, these Longhorn fans.
You mentioned outnumbered, Brent.
Makes it 7-0, Texas. So the 3 touchdown underdogs from Austin put the first touchdown on the board, and they made it look easy, didn't they? This is Chris Stockton. So they've gone to this leg to see if he can put it in the end zone. Stockton hooks it toward the corner and catches it. Now Nebraska trailing by 7. First and 10 on the 20. And here is junior quarterback Scott Frost handing off to D'Angelo Evans, the freshman, for 2 yards.
People think there's a problem here at this particular position. And he did almost toss one away on an option. But now he finds himself back by 7. He's going to be the focus here today.
Second down and 8. Frost rolls right, puts it up, whips one behind the receiver, and it is incomplete. Number 4 is a huge story here today. Amon Green did not even make the trip because of a stress fracture in his foot. So the freshman has to carry the load. Jay Sims, an untested high back, might be his backup. Brian Schuster became a daddy this week, so congratulations to his wife, who I'm sure is back home watching. He figures to be very prominent, number 28 does. On third down and eight, offensive
dead
line.
Ball. Ball start. Offense, 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
Chris Dishman. And I still feel he made one of the huge plays of the year that goes unlooked last week. Seemed like a touchdown. Third down and 14. So Frost goes straight down. Fires complete to the 25. Nebraska must punt. What is a white ceiling here in the dome in St. Louis? Push against that rush nails it. He is so good under pressure. 31, it's caught. Adams has a crease and caught from behind at the 37-yard line. Into a shift. Ricky Williams offset to the left of James Brown. Brown slips, regains balance, fires middle, deep, wide open, and it's the tight end Fitzgerald to the 40-yard line. 82 replaces Fitzgerald at tight end after the 23-yard gain. Brown with the draw play now on first and 10. Mitchell with speed trying to get the corner out of bounds at the 35. Second down, low right. Brown looking to throw it back on the screen. Now he's got to run away from Williams, and he eludes him to the 40. 39, he's going, and he breaks free. James Brown, the magician, to the 30-yard line. What a move. This the first third down play of the game for the Horns, who lead it by a touchdown. That's Fitzgerald back in the game in motion to the right, and you're right. Brown is back, fires, first down on the throw. And one thing, John Makovic. The Horns leading by seven and threatening again. Brown with a hot hand. 6 of 6 for 76 yards. Going to put it up the seventh time. No, incomplete. There's his first incompletion of the game.
It changes the entire complexion of the football game.
Quick count. Now Williams can't run away from it. Minner coming from the backside. They think fatigue could be a factor. They've gone to the second unit rush bin right now. Rucker at right end instead of Wisdom. Brown firing high. Complete. To the 7-yard line. First and goal again for the Horns, who are up 7. Mitchell on the draw, looking for the left corner. And that time it was well defended.
The tight end is over here on the left side. I should say Adams is the right side. Brown with good escapability. End zone intercepted.
Bad throw into the middle of the defense. And the Cornhuskers pick it off in the end zone. Eric Stokes, the free safety. Frost and the Huskers trailing by 7, run the option. Frost, a good running back, crashes out now to the 27. And there's big Chris Akins, number 96. He'll create, speaking of havoc, he'll be there. Humphrey, number 49, fine linebacker. And Bryant Westbrook, folks, you're going to watch number 30. He is lining up at the left corner, so it would be the quarterback's right. He's simply one of the best in the land. He's playing a little bump and run down here. Second down, D'Angelo looking for running room, and he's buried it.
Wins the lone running back, double tight formation, and Frost gets the first down.
And there are three wide receivers in this first down. Schuster, the fullback, figures to be used today. This is D'Angelo behind Schuster, and nothing doing in the defensive line.
But Nebraska comes up with here a pretty obvious passing situation. Second and 9, they'll run the option instead. Now the late pitch, and here's D'Angelo, nothing doing.
Helmet comes flying.
You can't take too many of those in a game.
For Sean Jackson, over to the left side is the tight end. And now Frost throws into the middle, and he hits number 25, and Ferdell makes it to midfield. John Federal.
That's right, first and 10, ball at midfield. Frost is going to throw it. Straight down the middle. Cheatham deflected. Incomplete. They trail it by a touchdown here. And Dr. Pepper. Big 12 championship. Straight down Frost. Sets the screen on the other side.
Got D'Angelo, and he's got it. To the 30. Fumble! Recovered, though, by Brendan Holbein. Here's D'Angelo. Bangs to the 19-yard line. So they load up. And here's the option. There's the pitch to D'Angelo. Nice tackle.
We've got a third and 3.
Approaching the half-minute mark left in the first quarter. Mahomes with the game's only touchdown. Frost keeps his cut back. Excellent, strong. Breaks free to the 3-yard line. First and goal.
Evans. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Well, that takes the pressure off the defense. They weren't planning on shutting them out.
In effect, this is a 100-yard drive. I know it won't look like that in the book, but don't forget that Nebraska intercepted the pass in the end zone. Throws up, holds it, and we are deadlocked. Alert play by Bedrill, and it's 7-7.
Played for the Northern Division title a week ago. And let's see where Brown rocks this one.
Oh, my. What a day.
Bring it out on the 20-yard line, and let's see what. And Frost is that. First and 10 for Brown in the horns. Adams, the motion receiver. Brown looking back at him on a screen. Flanker screen read beautifully that time.
The end of the first quarter. The Dr. Pepper Big 12 championship. Nebraska and Texas are even at 7 apiece. We'll be right back.
Penalty flag is thrown. Brown sideline incomplete. They come out with a slot to the right. McGarity, the slot receiver, Stokes backs away from him. Brown, Williams, bounces left. Nothing to it. Yeah, that will take care of that in a hurry. Third and 9. Brown, offensive line, holds, fires deep. Mike Foleman.
Ooh, nice play.
Back to return this. Moves up at the 36 cutback. And we come back. Nebraska will have the ball. Nebraska and Texas are tied. We're looking from behind D'Angelo Evans, number 4. The freshman I-back from Wichita, Kansas. And Frost using Schuster. Brian Schuster could spell Evans if they need another I-back. And here comes D'Angelo. Behind the left side to the 49-yard line. Wide receivers weren't certain, but I think Holbein, number 5, far out, and now Frost makes sure he has got the signal. He runs the option. Fumble! Texas goes for it. There's the fumble on the option, and it was number 49, Aaron Humphrey out of Lubbock, Texas. Over here on the left defensive side for the Huskers. First down for Brown. Ricky Williams steps, looks for a hole, and makes his way to the line. Young man, second down and 4 from the 32. Option pass. It's Mitchell. Throws deep. Incomplete. And he had Matt Davis wide open for the 3rd and 4. Split backs. Ricky's back in the game. Sean Mitchell.
They're blitzing inside.
Fire quick on the blitz. Incomplete. And long field goal by Phil Dawson. 49er. It's inside. It's on carpet. He has a long leg. You've got to give him a chance. Good hold. Ball was on the carpet, and Dawson did the rest. Very, very well done by Mark Schultes, the holder, who was able to get that ball in position for Phil Dawson, the junior from Dallas, who puts the Longhorns ahead of Nebraska for the 2nd time today. On the kickoffs, he did a good job the last time. This time, that's out of bounds. That's not so good. That's coming out on the 35-yard. Now, fumble on the option, and the Longhorns settle for the field goal that puts them ahead. So that's how we got to 10-7. Frost going to throw off the option. Look, Holbein diving catch at the 42-yard line.
I think it's a good decision. You know, you're not a passing team.
Second down and 3, and this is Sims, who has replaced D'Angelo Evans, junior from Omaha Central. Here's the option. Frost now gives it to Sims, and Sims crashes into Texas territory. Third on first down, then come back running the rest of the way. Here he's going to stay on the ground with Sims and see what he's got. Another yard on Bedrill. Fake Evans, cross back, going to go middle, deep, end zone, Holbein, Westbrook there, defended the play all the way.
They get the shotgun though, they can run the option, they can run the draw, and they also run the counter from it.
They showed that shotgun look. Inside shuffle, and it's D'Angelo to the 33-yard line.
His career long is 50.
So Bedrill the holder, they faked one last week against Colorado, ran the option. They have an inside shuttle too, but they're going to try the long one. And indoors, look at that leg.
Woo!
Both field goal kickers on the money.
Yeah. They love kickers when they can hit those big ones.
After the kickoff, went out of bounds. They'll let Brown kick this off.
Can't pay a guy like that enough.
First down and 10. James Brown is quarterback for the slot formation over to the left. They'll run the draw play off of it. And Williams breaking the first tackle is down at the 19-yard line. Second down and 4. Short drop on the slant. Beautiful for the first down. Out to the 39-yard line.
Back on the field. First down for the Horns. They run away from them this time.
And they bust one. Touchdown, Texas. Oh, baby. There'll be no catching the priest this time.
About that play. Again, it's a play that allows linemen to block down and shut the defense off inside. Then they kick out and pull a guard around.
Touchdown run. And Dawson adds it. And for the third time today, Texas, which came into this game a 3-touchdown underdog, leads the mighty Cornhuskers. I'm out. Well, a little bit straighter on the kickoff. And almost out of the end zone. That's the best kickoff. Nebraska hopes to do it, but to get a chance, they've got to come back to this. Here's the Angelo Evans screen over to the left. He was following Adam True and Dusty Renfro. Great Texas man. Made the stop that time. Second down and 7. Ross going to throw it, as all day. Fires out to Cheatham. Cheatham slipping has the first down for the Cornhuskers, and he'll go down at the 34-yard line. Frost eyes that defense. There is the hand signal Jack told you about. This is Evans. Comes to the right. Got a crushing block over there by number 75.
Not the guard. His wife and guard think so. I'll
Absolutely.
Tell you that.
And now Evans steps through that hole. After the measurement, the ball close to the 45-yard line. And that is the fullback. And that is a pounding football. Second down and 4. Sims back in the game. Frost breaks it off. Shows his athletic ability by making the most of that busted play. First down and 10. Ball on 42 yards. Not going to have a lot of time. Here's a play fake now to Sims. And Frost under fire. Throws it incomplete. And it'll be second and 10. Evans the eye back behind Makavica. Evans left side. Bolts through to the 32-yard line.
What a defensive unit. This is simply pounding away. First and 10 from the 31.
Frost with the option. Keeps it. And he gets wrapped up by Humphrey. Aaron Humphrey is perhaps the best of their linebacking corps. Horns. Evans, the lone running back, to show blitz. Frost keeps it. He bangs like a fullback. Third down and a long one. Toss. Evans tripped up. Slips free. First down. Gone.
The whole key to that play was the block by the wide receiver who was in a third back play, and he did a nice job of cutting the outside wide receiver.
Tied again. Coach, did you expect this one to be a high-scoring affair like we
got
so far?
No, I didn't.
Wild. 17-0. First and 10. Texas has been up 3 times. There it is. There's a man you like going out of bounds on it.
See how they're walking linebackers?
They'll run the toss, and here's Holmes on a cutback. He scored twice. 3 again. And he is to midfield.
Again, quick count. They weren't ready.
Ball's at midfield. First down.
Right
fires far side, and he's got number 83. Mighty might that day up in Champaign. Second down and 2. Now Brown. Going to go deep right side. Adam breaks free. Incomplete. complete, and he overthrew it.
His fault, not mine.
Ricky Williams offset to the left. And here comes Holmes. First down to the minute and a half. We're coming down to here in the first half. 34 points scored.
Brown got one on one. Marks Adams goes to him, and Booker gets a penalty.
Saying, wait a minute, that's not illegal. And he could be a good one yet. First down and 10. The ball is at the 22-yard line, and Brown in trouble. And that's what he does. Escape. Cuts back beautifully. Boy, did he save a big loss. Might be asking too much against this defense. Let's see. Second down and 9. Use motion to the right. Brown back. Intercepted. Beautiful play by the receiver. Third down and 9. The ball at the Cornhusker 20-yard line. There at the 14-yard line.
But he says, I got plenty of leg to make this one.
You bet he does.
So the 30-yarder that would put the Horns ahead with a minute left here in the first half. This would be the fourth time that they have led in the game. And there it is.
I think that was a good, sound decision. Your defense is playing halfway decent. You should have scored earlier on either field goal when they turned it going the other way.
A minute to go now, and Stockton has been handling the kickoffs.
You can cover those high kickoffs like that. That was up in the air. It's a good hang time.
Benning decides to bring it from 3 yards deep. 15, 20, and he's out to the 25-yard line. It means the Cornhuskers have only one timeout to work with, and that's certainly a restriction on offense for 53 seconds to go. Frost hangs on to the have an opportunity to show that to you. Here's Frost from the shotgun, firing in. Coming into the Christmas season. Third down and 5. Angelo spinning, twisting out to the 38-yard line.
He's tapered an aspirin to his forehead.
Meanwhile,
that's all golf run.
Look, here's Frost scrambling.
45-yard field goal. What do you think?
Cheetah and Benning back deep as we start the second half of the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. A bouncer. Benning at the 4-yard line. At the 20. Good return. Excellent field position.
On the Texas side.
A field goal difference right now with the Horns ahead. Option look. Oh. Ross going to make the toss now to Evans.
Did you see that?
Well, I was kind of. Second down and 2. Now Frost, hello. Down at the 39-yard line. Angelo Evans, the freshman from Wichita, Kansas, the I-back. Good time. Evans, right flat. Beats the linebacker. First down, Nebraska. On first down, Evans bounces left, and again he is cut off there. Second down and 11.
Okay.
Frost, option look. Here it is. Evans cut off. Takes his way to the 48. That's all. Well, here's a passing situation. Third and 10 for Frost. They set the screen. Evans and nothing doing this time. Tyson King. Let's put some heat on him. So that they're coming again. There, Jesse's real good at the pressure. There's the fair catch and out of bounds. The 18. Counter back with number 3, Sean Mitchell. He's back at that tailback spot. Williams offset on the right wing. Play fake. Brown steps away from pressure, comes middle, complete. Adams runs free, 45, midfield, 45, 40, and out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Not hesitating after the 47-yard gain. Quick count. Here's Williams, sprints over from left, looks for a seam, and he will be stopped at the 30-yard line. Picked up a couple of yards, young man's part. Second down and 7. The ball up the Nebraska 30-yard line. The Horns driving, and they lead it by 3. Brown. Waiting, going deep right side. Incomplete, had a man. Ball is at the 30-yard line. Brown will be in the shotgun. There's a handoff now. Williams is eaten up. That was, I believe, Jason Peter, number 55, who put it down on this 47-yard attempt. Nice to have a kicker like that. Well, it was a luxury and a 6-point lead. As the result of Dawson's third field goal of the first ever Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. Timeout.
switch. A short high. Cheatham fielding it at the 13-yard line. 25, and Cheatham will go down at the 28-yard line. Being done by Texas. And now Frost and the Cornhuskers come back out. All right. Got real estate. Frost down at the 35. Big moment for him here. Evans dives toward that first down marker. Dusty Renfro making the stop. An elimination game down the stretch for the Horns. Federal. This is Frost looking for his wide receiver. And he hit him at the 49-yard line. Again, close to another first down. It's now the ball close to midfield. Evans looking left. 9-yard run. Second down and one. The ball at the Longhorn 41-yard line. Frost pulls back out. Going to swing it out wide now to Evans. Evans twists. First down, Nebraska. The fullback. Schuster powering to the 34-yard line. Ball at the Horns 34. Frost on a cutback. He's to the 29-yard line. Evans, first down. Steps for 2 yards, and it'll be first and 10 for Frost. Runs the option. Keep it on a cutback. There was an alley there, and he makes his way to the 23. But on the edge of defensive lineman. That's Schuster. Powering to the 19-yard line. Close to another first down. It's third and one. Ball at the Horns 19, and this relentless march by the Huskers. Option look, late pitch, Evans, first down, out of bounds. Aaron Taylor, all those big fellas, you turn them loose, and they do just that. First down, Nebraska. To this Nebraska offense. Frost faking, slips a tackle, and barges to the 16. As they leave the Huskers here in second and nine. Fullback. Very close to the first down. Schuster. D'Angelo Evans deep in this first and goal. Frost option look. Pitch now. Evans tries to get the corner. Dives toward the end zone. And got it. Touchdown. Nebraska. We're tied. So that is three touchdowns for the freshman from Wichita, Kansas, D'Angelo Evans, having a big day as he steps in to replace the injured Amon Green.
All right, nice technique.
Now Malik. Chris Brown. So we've got timeout with Nebraska leading. Nebraska with its first lead. And he whacks it deep into the end zone. Mitchell will take a knee and it'll come out on the 20-yard line. Now Brown brings the offense up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing on first down and is tied in. Pat Fitzgerald. It's 24-23 Huskers. Here's the toss. Here's Williams looking for the left. Minter comes at him and rides him down. Penalty flag.
Because he might have gotten that stiff arm in the face.
First and 20 for the Hawks. Brown. Far side.
Great cover.
Outstanding cover. Stadium sounds like Lincoln, Nebraska right now. Williams. And they had a hold of his shoe. Tomich was in on the play. Brown under pressure. Tomich was coming. Going deep. Far side battle. And it's picked off. Warfield. Eric Warfield makes the interception for Nebraska. Frost makes the call. The big offensive line wearing him down. D'Angelo, the freshman, who certainly is no longer a freshman.
He was jumping up and down, and he congratulated each of them as they came off the field.
Use the fullback, which is Mac Avica, who that we will talk about when we come back, is why Coach Osborne wants this championship more than any other. Back with that in a moment. And if Dr. Tom gets a chance here today, he will not call the dogs off, but it's been tough going. D'Angelo steps over to the left, and he is short.
but he did get a first down.
10 and 1.
The Cadets, and they have earned it. First and 10 in Frost for Nebraska. Backfires middle, almost intercepted. Should have been picked off.
Second and 10, or puts it back in the air.
Has a slot receiver over here to the right. And he's going to run Evans, and nothing doing that time. This is third and 11.
Big play.
Big defensive stand so far for the Horns. Frost is going to put it up. Fired. Got his man. Holbein. First down, Nebraska at the 21-yard line. Brendan Holbein. Coach at Nebraska, the receiver. And Scott Frost hands down to D'Angelo. Cuts away, and he's tackled at the 18-yard line. Ball at the Horns' 18-yard line. Nebraska leads it by a point. Motion is started. This is Schuster. Alley cut back to the 12-yard line. Evans again inside the 10-yard line. Frost eyes the defense here on first and goal, and Schuster for a yard. Second down and goal. Ball is on the Horns' 9. Here comes the blitz. Frost inside pitch on the ground. Incomplete. Schuster and Evans behind Frost. Out of motion. Frost going to throw it. Waits. Right side high. Incomplete. Had it for a second.
Offside.
From the 4-yard line, across the quarterback, two tight ends. D'Angelo moves up behind him, and Frost changing up. Runs the option late. Pitch on the ground. How dangerous is that? Oh, baby. Federal, the holder. He'll check the outside rushman to see if they're going to come real hard off that far corner or the inside. And that puts them 4 points ahead with that field goal. So keep that in mind. A touchdown would have been a lot tougher mountain for Texas to climb than a 4-point deficit. We'll be right back. Nebraska leading Texas 27-23. Kicks it off toward the end zone again. This one will come out of the 20-yard line. For all intents and purposes, represent the difference. And on first down, Brown covered, slips away. He's beautiful on the move. Still going. Going to fire back. Dane got an open man. And it is his running back. Williams was free. First and 10 coming from the 37-yard line. Mitchell was getting a handle on the ball, I believe. So here is second and 13. Brown. Got it. McGarry in a foot race. Beat Stokes. He'll score. Wayne McGarry gives Texas a chance. 66 yards.
Now they'll kick it. Get the 3-point up there, and that time they ran that same double zone or double two safety secret, but they had a design pattern to go ahead and attack that kind of coverage.
Folks, Crouchy was coming over. Dawson pounds in the extra point.
Well, he was a great running back in high school, and he demonstrated that right there, Brent.
30-27. Texas leads Nebraska again. Timeout.
How many of you saw those hard kickoffs?
There's a high hooch type kickoff, bending at the 21-yard line, coming back to the left, and field position at the 29. Here's Evans to the short side, banged at the 31-yard line. Let's see what they come up with here on second and 8. They'll option it to the wide side of the field, and Frost is buried, coming out at the 34-yard line. Well, let's make it third down and a long. For the ball at the 34-yard line. Frost is going to throw it off a play fake. Had all day and hits the fullback. Schuster, first down, Nebraska. So they're
still in there.
Here he comes. D'Angelo. Short of midfield, but make it second and 5. Frost, there's the pitch now to Sims, who checks in. Fresh running back to the 39. First down, Nebraska. First down, and Sims again to the 40-yard line. Frost option long pitch to Evans. They stretch it out, cuts away from the first tackler. gains a couple of yards and no more. Here's third down and 4 yards. The ball at the Texas 38 for Nebraska.
Looks like they're lining up everybody.
D'Angelo didn't get it. It's fourth down, decision time for Osborne. Fourth down and 4. The ball on the 38. And Frost, the Nebraska quarterback, makes the call from the shotgun. D'Angelo Evans shifts to the other side of the formation. A numbers game. They're going to run it. There's a penalty flag, however, thrown by the referee.
They were trying to audible the direction of the
pass. That's against Nebraska.
Ball start.
Schuster, the up back. Low snap. He does get it off. And a beautiful punt. Carter makes the catch at the 6-yard line and on the line and everything that goes with it. And penalty fly whistle before the snap.
Dead ball. Ball start. Offense.
Half the distance. Second and 14. Motion by McGarrity. Brown slips. Rolls quickly to the right. Throws. What a catch. Did Fitzgerald have it? Yes, he did. Oh, brother. At the 12-yard line. So that puts it in second and 5. Remember, it was half the distance on the penalty. Now, Priest Holmes, who explodes. First down. Warfield cannot run. James Brown. Is he going to be the master prognosticator? Hands it off now. Mitchell, who is jammed up at the 20-yard line. That's only about a yard. Second down and 9 from the 20. Fake Holmes. Now he throws it on out to the running back, Williams. And he's wrestled out by Warfield.
Boy, it's a tough call.
Here is Holmes again to the 30. And if they spot it there, it's going to be a first down. Just an inch or so. Why not? Wouldn't you, coach? It's dangerous. No question what's about to happen. Fiebiger, number 58. On a roll. Gonna throw it. Got it wide open, baby. Derek Lewis in a foot race. And Jamel Williams has got him at the 10-yard line. What a call by McAvin.
What I tell you.
Does the rest. And now it is a first and 10 outside the 10-yard line. Here's Holmes. Cutback. Touchdown. Celebrating on the Texas sideline.
What a great, great, great job of coaching. The best job we have seen done, Brent, in a long time.
The third touchdown of the game for Priest Holmes. James Brown, come with me to Vegas, young man. You're the best prognosticator I've been around in a long time. Dawson. Sideline. The sands of time running out now on the champion. Less than 2 minutes to go for Nebraska.
The big money on the line. And there's that high kickoff. We're free to keep it right up there using Benning, sealing him at the 25. Not giving him a bust out, but he's still running, going laterally. And number 2 is $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund for outstanding students.
Cross fires Cheatham high, got it, fumble, they'll call it incomplete.
Talking about the Big 12 going into next season, you better believe it. Second down now. They make that direct.
She's inspired by her performance. Looks like he was a prophet about that.
He sure was, Jack, and as Dick has pointed out, this is a heck of a job. Tennessee, their chances for the Alliance, you would think that Colorado probably would fall out. Nebraska certainly would stay in it. There's a completion, although this figures to be. Frost with time. Intercepted King. This one's over, ladies and gentlemen. There's a penalty flag. Hold on.
Offside. Yeah. On the defense. 5-yard penalty. The team's first out.
No, he's an excellent football coach.
Out of bounds. That is the first down. Second Florida State in the Sugar Bowl is still to be determined.
Out of bounds. It was completed. 22-yard line. They want to stick it in the end zone and go to the onside kick as quickly as they can. Frost. Fumble. There it is.
Texas has done it. They have won the inaugural Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. They have upset three touchdown favorite Nebraska. Let's take a knee now. And it'll run out. We'll have a new champion this year, and still no team in the history of college football has been able to three-peat. They'll shake hands now at the 25-yard line. The Texas Longhorns have won the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. A 10-point victory by the underdogs as the Horns have done it.